Hey guys, welcome back to Down on Movies. I'm here for now. It is back for movie related stuff. I've been trying to get back into some talk wrestling stuff, but now we're here for movie things. And this is just going to be a fun, short, sweet weekly watch to discuss stuff that we've been watching this week. I'll do videos like this kind of every middle of the week, every week. I'll try to do that. So every time we watch a movie, I write it down in this nice little journal here. This awesome, amazing superhero binders, what I've been writing our weekly watch. So let's get to it. So basically, we have first up the Justice League versus the Teen Titans. It came out in 2016. I think I have it right here. It's on the shelf right here. So Justice League versus Teen Titans. Very, very awesome movie. So basically, it is directed by Sam, Liao Liu, and is basically where Raven's father is coming back to get her, and he's sending these little minions, and they're taking over kind of all the superheroes. They take over Superman, they take over Batman, they take over everybody, and the Justice League is trying to stop them and basically stop that. Trigon. I wrote it down here. See, I write my notes. Trigon. It features Nightwing. He is in it, obviously, because that was Robin before. The new Robin is Damian, who is Batman's son. If you've watched all the Batman versus Robin or Batman... Son of Batman. I couldn't think of that. Wow, I'm an idiot. So there's that. Very, very awesome movie. Good action. Good animated movie. I think if you haven't seen it, check it out. Awesome. So that's that. The next one is The Frighteners, starring Michael J. Fox. It is directed by Peter Jackson. It is Michael J. Fox, Dee Wallace, Jake Busey, and Trini Alvarado. And that is a really fun one. It came out in 96. Which I didn't know it was directed by Peter Jackson, and it's Robert Zemeckis film, which is, I think, is awesome. This is a movie that I've heard about a lot. I've seen it everywhere, but never had a chance to actually sit down and see it. And the Alamo Drafthouse was showing of it, doing a Frighteners night. And they, so Starla invited Caitlin and I to go see it. Very well done. Really funny. And it was not exactly what I expected, but, Michael J. Fox basically plays a guy who seems like a fraud on the outside, where he can go around and do paranormal stuff, but he can actually really see ghosts, and he uses them to help basically scam people into paying him money to get rid of these ghosts. And then all of a sudden he starts seeing these numbers appear on people's heads, and so he uses those ghosts to figure out, I guess, like death is basically going around killing everyone. So it's really good, really funny, but also has some scary moments, mystery. Next up is The Ice Princess. It stars Michelle Trachtenberg, has Joan Cusack, Hayden Panettiere, and Kim Cattrall. Came out 2005. It has a special appearance from Michelle Kwan, which my mom used to love back in the day, which is really cool. It's directed by Tim Fywell. And basically is about this girl who's a little bit nerdy, a little bit geeky. She's real big into physics, and so she gets assigned, but as a side project, she loves to ice skate. So, her physics teacher basically tells her, as a final project, go out and do something that you're passionate about to make your Harvard application look better. And so she basically decides to do ice skating, and instead she ends up getting more passionate about that because that's what she really wants to do, while also her mom, who's played by Joan Cusack, wants her to do, she wants her to push her to Harvard and to physics and all that stuff. Hayden Panettiere is somebody who is in her grade, who is kind of a bully, but becomes real close friends with Michelle Trachtenberg. Kim Cattrall plays her mom, who's kind of controlling. So it's kind of, you have these two aspects of these two girls who are passionate about other things, and their mom's very controlling. So very well done movie. It was, I guess, came out, was it Disney? I think it was, yeah. Disney movie. I'd never seen it. Caitlin wanted to watch it, so very well done. Next up is Batman v Superman, the Ultimate Edition. We bought that on Blu-ray. I think you can kind of see it if you look at the Funko shelf right over there. You can kind of see it on top of the Funkos, which, you know, I did an unboxing of. It was the Wally pick of the day. It came out in 2016, which is directed by Zack Snyder, which obviously everybody knows, has Ben Affleck, Henry Cavill, Amy Adams, Jesse Eisenberg, holy cow, Diane Lane, Lawrence Fishburne, Jeremy Irons, Holly Hunter, and Gail Gabbett. I had to write down everyone, so that was a big breath, so I apologize for talking so fast, but very good movie. I think the Ultimate Edition is so damn long, but you need it. You need to watch it, because it actually, it helps a little bit, you know. It makes it more of a cohesive movie, even though it's still not a super cohesive movie. It helps a lot be more cohesive, so I definitely recommend checking out the Ultimate Edition. Next up is Ella Enchanted. It is a really fun one. It stars was Anne Hathaway. She is kind of like a tale on Cinderella, but basically she gets cursed by one of her fairy godmothers as a baby to be obedient. And so she basically, no matter what you tell her, she has to do. And so she just kind of learns with this. She grows up with people telling her, you know, go rob this, go do that, and she has to do it. And so basically the whole movie is her trying to figure out, find her fairy godmother and help her get rid of this obedience. So it's really, it's a fun one. Next up is we've been watching some older movies, kind of peppering things in. So we watched Beauty and the Beast, and which is, I mean, what can you say about Beauty and the Beast? It is amazing. Great music. It's a fun one to watch. Let me have it right here. We have it on Blu-ray right here. And we bought the cover, or not the cover. I really love this cover. I know you can't tell right here, but it's so damn shiny. It gives me giggles. Giggles. But it's awesome. So yeah, Beauty and the Beast. One of the best ones by Disney. And last but not least, which I was going to do a single review on, but instead I saved it for the weekly watch, and that is Lights Out. This is the one that just came out last weekend. It is about this girl, girl, her brother, and her mom trying to share this story of, you know, there's this, obviously when you turn off the lights, these crazy things happen, and it twists and turns, find out where the mom, we used to be friends with a girl in this lady in the dark who's just kind of, you can only see her when the lights are out. Very well done horror movie. I think it has its creepy moments. It's subtle. It didn't need to feel like it's all over the place, and it was actually really well done. So check that out. And I feel out of breath because I'm talking so damn fast, but that's because I didn't want this to be a long video. But that's it. So that is the weekly watched for week one. So thank you guys so much for watching my weekly watch, and make sure you give this video a thumbs up and let me know in the comment section down below some things you've been watching. And that's about it. So thank you guys. We'll see you next time.